Trigonometric ratios of multiple and submultiple angles. Trigonometric ratios of angle 3A or 3 theta in terms of A. So first is sine 3A is equal to 3 sine A or theta minus 4 sine cube A. So how do we prove this? We know that sine A plus B is sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. So I'm going to write sine as S and cos as C. So write this sine 3A can be written as A plus 2A. Let us write it here, A plus 2A. So how does this become? This is sine A and cos 2A plus cos A and sine 2A. So we have sine A. So this sine A, I'm writing S, this cos 2A. Cos 2A can be written as, cos 2A, we know that it can be written as 1 minus 2 sine square A. So I'm writing 1 minus 2 sine square plus. So this is cos A. And this sine 2A can be written as, we know that sine 2A is 2 sine A cos A. So this is, already we have this cos A. Then we have this sine 2A as 2 sine A cos A. So let us multiply it, sine minus 2 sine cube plus this is 2 sine and cos square. Now cos square is 1 minus sine square because cos square plus sine square is 1. So I am writing in place of cos square 1 minus sine square. This will be sine minus 2 sine cube plus now 2 sine minus 2 into sine into this sine cube. So now this sine and sine will become 3 sine and this 2 and 2 minus 4 sine cube. So ultimately this will be 2 sine A, 3 sine A minus 4 sine cube A. So this is the formula proof. So this is sine A. If you want to find out sine 3A, if you want to find out sine A, what you will do? Just make it A by 3. So 3 sine A by 3 minus 4 sine cube A by 3. Now we know about cos A plus B. So that formula we are going to use for cos 3A. So cos 3A is what? Let me tell you that cos 3A can be written as cos A plus 2A. Now cos A plus B, the formula of cos A plus B is cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. So cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. So I am going to write B as 2A here for this. It will be cos A cos 2A minus sin A sin 2A. So now cos A cos 2A can be written as, cos 2A can be written as now 2 cos square A minus 1. This cos 2A. Let us use it here. Cos 2A is 2 cos square A minus 1. So 2 cos square A minus 1. Then we have minus. This sine A is sine A only. And this sine 2A again 2 sine A cos A. Sine 2A is, so let us write 2 sine A cos A. This will become 2 cos cube minus cos. And this sine and sine will be sine square. So let us take 2 cos here and in sine square theta equal to 1 minus cos square theta. So I'm writing 1 minus cos square theta. This will be 2 cos cube minus cos minus 2 cos plus 2 cos cube. So this 2c that is 4 cos cube A minus this is 3 cos A. So this is the formula of cos 3A. If you want to find out cos A, just make it A by 3. We have sine 3A, we have cos 3A, just divide them, you will get tan 3A. tan 3a is simply 3 tan a minus tan cube a by 1 minus 3 tan square a. So if you divide that, you will get, just divide this and divide numerator and denominator by cos. But I'll tell you, let us use the formula. So let me give the proper proof of tan 3a. So tan a plus b is what? It is tan a plus tan b by 1 minus tan a tan b. So in order to find out tan 3a, let us write it as tan a plus 2a. So this will become what? This will become tan a. I am writing now this tan a plus, in place of b, tan 2a by 1 minus tan a tan 2a. But we know that this tan 2a is 2 tan a by 1 minus tan square a. This we have already proved in the earlier discussions. So let me write it here. This tan a plus this 2 tan a by 1 minus tan square a. This is 1 minus tan a into tan 2a is 2 tan a by 1 minus tan square. So let us take the LCM. This will be tan 1 minus tan square. This will be 2 tan divided by 1 minus tan square. The denominator will have, this is 2t square now. So 1 minus t square, 1 minus tan square minus 2 tan square by 1 minus tan square. So this gets cancelled. So this will be what? Tan minus tan cube. This will be tan minus tan cube. And this will be plus 2 tan a. The denominator will have 1 minus tan square minus 2 tan square. So this 2t, that is 2, this will be 3 tan a minus, this will be tan cube a by, this will be 1 minus, this will be 3 tan square a. This is the proof of tan 3 also.